Now we are going to study different types of budget deficit. So budgetary deficit refers to excess of the total budgeted expenditure, both revenue expenditure as well as capital expenditure over total budgetary receipts, both revenue receipts and capital receipts. In other words, when the sum of the revenue receipts and the capital receipts fall short of the sum of revenue expenditure and capital expenditure, budgetary deficit is said to occur. Symbolically, as you can see, budgetary deficit is equal to total expenditure minus total receipts. There are three types of budget deficit: revenue deficit, fiscal deficit, and primary deficit. Let us study revenue deficit. Revenue deficit refers to the excess of revenue expenditure of the government over its revenue receipts. Symbolically, revenue deficit is equal to total revenue expenditure minus total revenue receipts. Now, what are its implications? Revenue deficit indicates this saving on the government account because the government has to make up uncovered gap. Revenue deficit implies that the government has to cover this uncovered gap by drawing upon capital receipts either through borrowing or through sale of its assets. Since government is using capital receipts to generally meet consumption expenditure of the government, it leads to inflationary situation in the economy. Measures to reduce revenue deficit are: government should reduce its unproductive or unnecessary expenditures. Government should increase its receipts from various sources of tax and non-tax revenues. Fiscal deficit. Fiscal deficit is defined as an excess of total expenditure over total receipts. That it includes both revenue and capital receipts, excluding borrowing, in the form of an equation, as you can see in the slide. Fiscal deficit is a measure of total borrowings required by the government. Fiscal deficit indicates capacity of a country to borrow in relation to what it produces. In other words, it shows the extent of government dependence on borrowings to meet the budget expenditure. Another point to be noted here is that the government borrowing increases its liability in future to repay loan with the interest also increases, leading to higher revenue deficit. Therefore, fiscal deficit should be as low as possible. Now, what are the implications? First of all, it causes inflation. That is a very important component of government borrowing that includes borrowing from the Reserve Bank of India. This invariably implies deficit financing or meeting the deficit requirements of the government by way of printing more currency. This is a dangerous practice. Through a very convenient for the government, it increases circulation of money and causes inflation. Number two is increase in foreign dependence. Government also borrows from rest of the world. It increases our dependence on other countries. Foreign borrowings is often associated with economic and political interferences by the lender countries. It increases our economic slavery. Third is financial burden for future generations. Borrowing implies accumulation of financial burdens for the future generations. It is the future generation to repay loans as well as the mounting interest thereon. Deficits multiply borrowings. Payment of interest increases revenue expenditure of the government, causing an increase in its revenue and deficit. Thus, a vicious circle is set wherein the government takes more loans to repay earlier loans, which is called debt trap. So now, what is primary deficit? Primary deficit is defined as fiscal deficit minus interest payments. And its implications are: While fiscal deficit shows borrowing requirement of the government for financing the expenditure inclusive of interest payments, primary deficit reflects the borrowing requirements of the government for meeting expenditures other than interest payments on earlier loans. Thank you.